Shala Gupta from Inventive, and we are back with another episode of today's news headlines. The antibodies we create after we are infected with a virus or vaccinated against it can be very powerful. A virus typically spreads within our bodies by entering a cell and using it as a factory to create more copies of itself, which then burst out and find new cells to infect. Our antibodies work by binding to the virus, and this can block it from attaching to and entering our cells in the first place. But what happens if a virus does not need to exit the cell in order to spread to neighboring cells? Can our antibodies be effective against it? Scientists recently asked this question for SARS-CoV-2, which causes COVID-19. This highly infectious coronavirus can change human cells, making them fuse with two or more nearby cells. These supercells with large merged cells bodies are excellent viral factories. The supercells, known as syncytia, share multiple nuclei, the part of the cell that contains that genetic material, and abundant cytoplasm, the jelly-like substance that surrounds the nucleus. Having more of these components is one giant cell, helps the virus replicate more efficiently. And by fusing cells, SARS-CoV-2 increases its resources without being exposed to the neutralizing antibodies that slosh around outside our cells. The study by Alex Siegel and colleagues tested two coronavirus variants, Alpha and Beta, for their ability to transmit from cell to cell and investigated whether this mode of transmission was sensitive to antibody neutralization. The Alpha variant, first identified in the UK, is sensitive to antibodies, and the Beta variant, first identified in South Africa, is less sensitive to these antibodies. The Siegel study, which is yet to be published in scientific journal, revealed that cell-to-cell transmission with both variants successfully evaded antibody neutralization. This shows that when the virus takes hold, it will be more difficult to eliminate in cells that can fuse with each other. Viruses have coexisted with humans and animals for millennia, so they have evolved tricks to avoid being recognized by our immune system. Such an immune evasion strategy is the direct transmission from cell to cell, which does not always require cell fusion. It is also possible for viruses to travel to their next host cells by exploiting tight associations between neighboring cells that shield them from antibodies. It is reasonable to assume that antibodies are most effective at preventing entry into the host cell and less effective in the parts of body where infection is already established. Does this mean that our vaccines will be ineffective against viruses that move directly from cell to cell? Luckily, our immune system has also evolved alongside viruses, and we have learned to build defenses that work in many ways. That's all for today. We'll be signing off. I'll be back with some more news. Till then, stay safe and stay connected. Thank you.